I'm actually doing a signing here at the Warrior Clothing Shop. And then I'm doing a seminar in a second at Pound for Pound. And then I'm going to be viewing the fights over at Off the Rail.
Now talk about how things have changed for you since obviously winning the show and now establishing your career in the Ultimate Fighting Championship, really touring around the world. Is it a pretty grueling schedule?
Honestly, yeah, it's really hectic. This time I brought my wife with me. So I'm going to fight camp to New Mexico with Greg Jackson. Here, literally, I fly here that way and she flies home. So that's why I brought it this time, so I could be able to hang out. And Toronto, by far, is my favorite place in Canada. I haven't been to Vancouver yet, but it blows Winnipeg and Montreal away.
Now talk about the fans and the different places that you go to. How important is it to show them who you are?
I think it's very important that everyone sees the type of person you are, you know, and you should always be the same person around everyone, not just, you know, oh, it's an act or this, that, and the other. I can't act, so like on TV, you know, you get what you see. When you see a dork, it's a dork. When I misspell towel, you know, I misspell towel.
What's your favorite thing about traveling around?
It's when I get to go with my wife and enjoy things with her. Sometimes, like, it is business. You know, I'm going for my buddy is fighting, so it's not really fun because you're sitting there, you're worried about finding rehydration, finding a place to train, finding a safe environment, finding the right food. All these things build up. And whereas this has actually been a little bit of a vacation, one of the most busiest appearances I've ever done. In fact, it is the busiest. However, it's been fun because the people around me are awesome.
And what's your goals? Talk about...
I want the belt so bad.
Why is that? Why is that the goal for everybody to go and... I understand they want to test themselves.
Then you get the belt, and then you want to defend the belt. Then you defend the belt, and you want to get the most defenses. And it's just because we're competitors and we're championship. And when champion is, like, in the top-level competitor, like, atmosphere, then it's just a strive for excellence.
But if you look at a guy like Clay Guida, for example, a guy that everybody loves to watch fight, and at the end of the day, you know, when his career is done, say he doesn't win a title, everybody's going to love Clay Guida because every time he comes out there, he puts on a show, he comes out to fight. How important is it to just think about putting on a show and entertaining fans?
Honestly, to me, it's important. However, it's never thought about. I just go out there to fight. And, like, I'll call the crowd because it feels so good to feel the you don't even hear it. You feel the noise because, like, you're kind of in tunnel vision, but you can feel, like, the scream. It's like 15,000, 20,000 people. It's amazing, you know. But that should be in the person. You shouldn't have to tell yourself, oh, no, I got to do this, because then you're not thinking about enough to win.
Yourself excluded, who's the best fighter in the world?
If I had to exclude myself, I would still find myself somewhere there. But Dan Henderson is.
Why?
Because he graduated from Victorville High School, his dad coached me, and he's one of my idols.
What do you love about mixed martial arts?
I guess it's that no matter who you are, no matter what size you are, you can find your niche and you can become great.
Why do you do it?
Just kind of said a funny answer there, but I didn't. I do it honestly because I want to be the best.